Good morning, children. Today we are going to start with another topic, the Browning version by Terence Rattigan. In this chapter, the Browning version, it is a play that cremated Terence Rattigan's reputation as a serious, mature playwright. It is viewed as one of his best work and one of the best one acts ever written. The first performed at Phoenix Theatre, London, England on September 8, 1948. The Browning version was coupled with another one act by Rattigan entitled Harlequinade under the umbrella name E. Pabel. This show ran for 245 performances and Rattigan received the Ellen Terry Award for the Browning version, his second. The first was won 2 years earlier for The Winslow's Boy. The Browning version made its New York debut with Harlington on October 12, 1949, but only ran for 62 performances. The praise from British audience and critics was nearly universal when the play was performed in England. About the author, Terence Rattigan was born on June 10, 1911, in London, England. His father, William, was a career diplomat and served in countries such as Turkey, Romania, while his parents lived abroad. Terence and his brother were raised by their grandparents in England. Rattigan was about 11 years old when his parents returned. By that time, he has fallen in love with reading and going to plays. He wrote his first play about at the age of 10. Rattigan was educated at the Harrow School from 1925 until 1930, when he entered Trinity College, Oxford. His experience at the former public school informed such plays as the Browning version. Although Rattigan was training for the diplomatic course, by the time he reached Oxford, his interaction was focused on the stage. Now about the story, the main course textbook it's taken, that is Hornbill. It includes a small part of play in it. The scene begins with Taplow, he's a student, and Frank, a science master, who starts a conversation while waiting outside for Mr. Crocker Harris' room. Now what happens, this is a play which highlights the attitude of a teenage student, Frank, towards his teacher. Moreover, his remarks are awful because they are very close to reality. He mimics the voice of Mr. Crocker Harris and calls the man practically inhuman. He is extremely fearful of his teacher. Moreover, his promotion depends upon the quirk or the goodwill of his teacher. However, he opens up when the other science teacher encourages him to do so. Further, the teenager hates Greek play because he does not like the teacher methods of the Greek play which I mentioned. It is Egemon. Okay, because he does not like the teacher's method of teaching. Besides, in order to make them like him, Mr. Crocker Harris seems to hate people. In addition, this description of a teacher is damaging and ultimately it reflects the hopeless quality of the teachers. Now, this is a play whose first scene is set in a school. In the opening, there is a 16-year-old boy, Taplow. He has come to do some extra work for his teacher, Mr. Crocker Harris. Moreover, he has to wait for him as he still has to arrive. Frank, another teacher, he deems Taplow's waiting and strikes a conversation with him. During the conversation, Frank gets to know that Taplow is waiting for his result, which is yet to be handed out. The boy is keen to specialize in science and hope to get a good result. Mr. Crocker Harris does not declare the result himself. Instead, he requests the headmaster to declare the result on the last day of the term. The conversation also delivers the insight of Taplow's mind. He tells Frank how much he dislikes the play Agamemnon. He confesses that the play is not that bad, but he likes science. Also, he points out that the way Mr. Harris teaches it is terrible. They have to do extra work as he missed a class a week ago. Certainly, Frank remarks that Taplow will get his removed for doing extra work. However, Taplow feels different as he is not like other teachers. So, such rules does not work with Mr. Crocker Harris. Taplow states, also, he doesn't appreciate the extra work of students. As per Taplow, Mr. Harris is different from the other teachers. He is strict and inhuman. Moreover, he does not tell them their results before the judgment day. When Taplow asks about his remove, Crocker Harris says that it is exactly what he deserves, no less and certainly no more. Frank pointed out that Crocker Harris is 10 minutes late and Taplow has a chance to leave and play golf. But Taplow looks shocked at the suggestion as he thinks that Mr. Crocker Harris might follow him home. Frank envies Mr. Harris for the influence he has on his students. When Frank asks Taplow that if Mr. Harris beats him, Taplow replies that he is not a sadist and he is not a person who would beat student and vent his frustration out on them. In spite of all this, he likes Mr. Harris and narrates an incident when he laughs at the classical joke that Mr. Harris, although he didn't get it. After that, Millie, Crocker Harris' wife, she enters the room. She suggests Taplow for a quarter an hour and come back, as Mr. Harris has been at Bursar's and may take quite a time. Mrs. Harris' behavior puzzles Taplow. Taplow is not willing to leave as he doesn't want to disobey the teacher whom he fears. When Millie assures Taplow that she will take the blame and proposes an excuse for his absence, Millie hands Taplow a prescription and asks him to take it to the chemist and get it for Harris. So Taplow accepts the proposal and leaves Frank and Mr. Harris behind. Now, if you see the character sketch, Mr. Crocker Harris is a middle-aged teacher. He is quite reserved and doesn't mix up with his students. He maintains some distance with them. Crocker Harris, a strict follower of rules. Mr. Crocker Harris follows them very strictly. In this regard, he is different from other teachers. He never leaks out results till they are formally announced. He has a wonderful hold over his students. They are scared of him. Crocker Harris shriveled inside like a nut. Taplow says that Crocker Harris is shriveled inside like a nut. It is quite true. He is not open. He doesn't like flattery, nor does he like anyone who likes him. He is hard taskmaster. He gives extra work to Taplow even on the last day of the school. This he does to punish Taplow for being absent for a day last week. Sometimes he cracks joke. His classical jokes lacks a humor. No one understands them except him. They are as dry and humorless as he himself is. So we have seen about Mr. Crocker Harris' character and his personality. That in spite Taplow was very scared of Mr. Crocker Harris as a teacher, but he was not scared of the person he was. He used to always laugh at the jokes in the classroom. None of them would laugh, but Taplow, he used to make him feel good by laughing at the jokes which he used to share. So Taplow, he was a student who liked Crocker Harris from the teacher viewpoint, and he used to adorn him as a teacher. Frank is quite open to his students. He doesn't keep any distance while dealing with his students. Taplow is not a student of his class, but still he takes a lot of interest in him. His long conversation with Taplow reveals his open nature. Frank doesn't believe in observing formalities. He cares little regarding rules and regulations. Mr. Crocker Harris is feared and even respected. He has a wonderful hold over his students. They are scared of him. Frank admits that he is envious of Mr. Crocker Harris. Perhaps he locks that effect which Harris has lit over his students. Frank encourages Taplow to criticize Crocker Harris. Actually, he urges him to intimate Harris. This clearly reveals the working out of his mind. He even asks Taplow to cut Crocker Harris. He lacks Harris' devotions. He teaches science but shows no interest in his subjects. This shows his lack of dedication and commitment towards his profession. Now, Frank is very envious of Mr. Crocker Harris. So, seeing Taplow working for Mr. Crocker Harris on the last day even of his retirement, he is very much envious and jealous of Mr. Crocker Harris. So, he tries to cut down and he tries to take out the conversation from him that definitely Mr. Crocker Harris would have shown you the results. Because Taplow... he has to get the level 5 grade to promote into another class. Class, for example, 5th A, B, C, D. So for reaching A level to B level, B level to C level, he has to pass certain grades. So Mr. Frank, he tried to influence Taplow that definitely Mr. Crocker Harris had shown the results to Taplow. But this wasn't the situation of Taplow with Mr. Crocker Harris. He was a very obedient and very sincere teacher. Taplow is a boy of 16 studying in lower fifth. Lower fifth means now he has to pass on more grades of fifth standard, like A, B and C levels of fifth standard, okay, in order to clear all the fifth level and reach the sixth level. His attitude towards his Mr. Crocker Harris was quite mixed. He recognized his sense of discipline, sense of devotion and stoic nature. But he had personal grudge against Mr. Crocker Harris. He had to do some extra work on the last day of the school. Taplow was a bit anxious about his result. He afraid that Harris might have marked him down. Taplow considered Mr. Crocker Harris different from other teachers. Taplow, see, when a student does the work for a teacher, every other student feels that definitely the teacher is favoring the student, or the student is in the sweet side of the teacher. So, but this is not the situation. And therefore, this is not the situation which Taplow believed in the case of Mr. Crocker Harris. Taplow criticized him for being less, yet regards him an extraordinary man. He was mortally afraid of him, but never called him sadist. Taplow called his jokes classical and dry and condemned him for being little emotional. He didn't like flattery and couldn't be flattered. Though he hated people to like him, Taplow rather liked him. He recognized the qualities of his teacher and never failed to praise those qualities before others. That means of a teacher, he liked the qualities very well. But as a person, he used to less like the Crocker Harris. Andrew Crocker Harris is a character teacher at an English boys' school. After he played is his last day before moving on to a position at another school. So we'll see the climax part of it. The students speculate on why he is leaving, but do not care, since despite being academically brilliant, he is generally despised as being strict, stern and humorless. They have nicknamed him the Croc. Even the school administrator treat him poorly regardless of his long tenure. Millie Crocker Harris, his wife, is younger and vivacious and quite different from her husband. She no longer loves him, but rather loves Frank Hunter, another teacher. Yet despite having an affair with him, she knows he is not in love with her. On this last day, one student named Taplow, who does not hate Crocker Harris but feels sorry for him, gives a small going away gift. The gift brings about a series of action which makes Crocker Harris reflect on his past, contemplate his future and evaluate how he is going to finish his tenure at the school. So this is all about a small story. Through the Browning version summary, the writer wants to say that teachers are not as bad as they seem. All they want is good for their student. So I want students to go through this chapter. Okay, now y'all are having enough of time. Go through this video, rewind the video and again, okay, and clear your doubts.